we have already completed 4 essays. However, it was in a haphazard way. I couldn't tell you about the process, how to write an essay. So essay is nothing but jotting down some points to tell about a topic. It should be in a logical way. Let's see what are the ingredients of an essay. So first, try to understand the topic clearly from all angles. So that is very important thing. You, whatever essay is given to you, you should understand the topic first. And then try to think from all angles. For example, how to write an introduction. Maybe you have to write about the purpose. Maybe about you have to write about advantages, disadvantages, etc. So the essay, different essays have different techniques. So you have to think about that. Concentrate coolly. Number two, concentrate coolly and carefully jot down the points. So after once you have made the skeleton, jot down the points in paragraphs. Discuss logically and writer's original ideas must be included. So it is very important to discuss everything in a logical way. You have to give reasons. Logical means what? You have to give reasons. So you have to also include writer's original view if it is needed. And your view also you can give according to its needs. Then chalk down the outline of the essay. If the outline is given, you are fortunate. If it is not given, make the outline or the skeleton. For example, introduction, after that what will come next. Number five, arrange these points logically or in a logical order. So already discussed. Number six, separate paragraphs should be used for different points. So I have seen many students have used to write the essay in one single paragraph. Is it an essay? It is paragraph, not an essay. So according to the points, different points, you have to make different paragraphs. Language should be simple, clear and direct. It should not be too long. The sentences should not be too long, because in long sentences you often make mistakes. So you are just a school going students. So it is better to advise you to be simple, clear and direct. Go through the essay carefully to see the structure after finishing. So once you have completed, just go through it. If there is any mistake, any spelling mistake may be there, or even a structure, maybe some kind of error you may notice after once you revise that. The length should not be too long. Most often in your question paper, the word limit is given. So see about that. So if you know about it previously, you make that design. Don't make too long essays. The invigilator may not like to read everything. So better to be simple and sweet. And there are four types of essays. Descriptive, describe about person, things, machines. Narrative, journey, visit, matches, etc. Reflexive, for example, habits, feelings, social topics, etc. And imaginative, if I were Prime Minister of India, these are imaginative. So the essay should have beginning, a body and a conclusion. So now let's see, I have given 4 essays. Let's see that.
Discipline. The more disciplined you become, the easier life gets, the famous saying. The concept of discipline is as old as man's desire to form society. In fact, discipline is the prerequisite of civilized life. It is indispensable to peaceful and orderly social life. Obedience to the rightful authority is essential to the proper and smooth functioning of a society. Discipline is the base of the whole universe. The earth, the moon, and the other planets move on a set of orbit around the sun. The sun rises and sets, the moon waves and wanes, the night follows the day in due order. All these phenomena are governed by some law of nature. Because of this discipline, there is perfect harmony and beauty in nature. Discipline starts from home. The home is nursery where we receive and first lesson of discipline through obedience to parents and elders. As we pass out of the nursery and enter the portal of an educational institution, the discipline becomes a matter of vital importance. That is because students' life is a period of preparation for the bottle of life. No less is the need for discipline in the playground. There are men, however, who are opposed to discipline. They think that it kills originality and takes away initiative. Disciplined people, they say, are just like parts of machinery. He therefore should not be expected to be obediently and orderly. Discipline is the extreme of authoritarianism. The only demand that discipline makes is that you would have a plan and an order. Discipline is a precious asset. Life without discipline is like a ship without a rudder. It is rod to check the erring, a brake to control thoughtless action of man. Its purpose is to see that liberty does not degenerate into license. Media. The biggest revolution in the history of communication is social media, and this started a completely new era altogether. Every platform that enables us to communicate and socialize locally and globally is social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and WhatsApp are its many avatars. Social media allows us to fellowship with people from all corners of the world. It gives us a sense of a global community where we are no more divided by political powers but united by our thoughts and interests. We can always keep in touch with people from all walks of our life, a boon that seemed impossible until social media showed up. It gives the common man a platform to voice with complete freedom expression, be it for supporting a cause or for addressing a national or international issue of any sensitivity. Business prospects and job opportunities gear up as social media is a stage with global audience to showcase our talents. The biggest drawback of social media is that it is highly addictive to almost every person using it. It has altered our sense of reality such that in priding the global connectivity it offers, we forget to connect with the people around us and grow emotionally distant. This obsession of being glued to our gadget screens all day brings with it an array of health disorders and is the main cause of stress, depression, anxiety, and sleeplessness. Social media has expanded the horizon of communication more than ever and has changed the pace of life forever. While eliminating social media from our lives is out of question, its uses can be moderated by limiting our time on it. To end with Tom H.C. Anderson, by not tweeting, you are tweeting, you are sending a message. Historical place. Fill your life with adventures, not things. Have stories to tell, not stuff to show, goes the famous saying. Historical places provide a peep into our history and reminds us of the glorious and wonderful days of the past. I'm much fortunate to write that I live in a historically rich place, Sivasagar, where many tourists, both national and international, come to visit every year, every season. Sivasagar, named after its ruler Siva Singha, is a city of great historical importance in Assam. Sivasagar, named after its ruler Siva Singha, is a city of great historical importance in Assam. It may be called the pride of Assam due to its rich cultural heritage and historical importance. Once it was the capital of the great Ahom kingdom, the brave dynasty who ruled Ahom for glorious 600 years before the onset of British rule in India. Its ancient name is Rongpur. The city is surrounded by a large number of monuments, including historical tanks, temples, palaces, etc. Among various places of attraction, the Jaisagar Tank, the Lord Shiva's Temple, the Sivsagar Tank, the Ranghar, the Talatal Ghar are worth mentioning. The Jaisagar Tank is the lake which is the largest man-made lake within the world. It was constructed by Swargadev Rudra Singha in the memory of his mother Sati Jayamati. The Gauri Sagar Tank is another significant tourist attraction of Sivsagar. It was constructed by the wife of Ahom King, Phuleswari Devi. The renowned historic tank, the Sivsagar Tank, is situated at the heart of Sivsagar. It was constructed by Queen Ambika, consort of Siv Singha. This tank is surrounded by three temples, Siv Dol, Vishnu Dol, Devi Dol. Among these three, Siva Dol is the point of attraction. The 7-foot golden dome called Kolosi is situated at the topmost part of the temple. The Lord Vishnu Temple is situated near to Siv Temple, and the Lord Devi Temple is situated at the near of it. Another noteworthy edifice which attracts a large number of tourists is the Ranghar. It is built by King Pramatha Singha, and this wonderful structure is called the first amphitheater and has been known as Colosseum of the East. The Namdang Stone Bridge was built by King Rudra Singha and was 60 meters long. One of the popular tourist spot of Sivsagar is Charaideo. Sukapa established its capital at Charaideo. Every year, large number of tourists from every nook and corner of the world come to this beautiful place to stay a few days away from hustle and bustle of the city life. So here it should be corner. Nook and corner. Okay. Exercise. To enjoy the glow of good health, you must exercise. Jain Tani. Physical exercise is widely recognized as the best way to keep the body healthy and active. Neglect of bodily health can be disastrous for us. It causes several physical and mental problems. Slowly, and our body becomes vulnerable to many diseases. His energy and beauty is lost early. Strength, stamina, and power of concentration declines. Physical exercise is of different kind. Different people have different choices and preferences. Many people enjoy morning walks. Some find pleasure in cycling and jogging. Several people like to do gardening or swimming. Skipping is also a popular way to keep one's body fit and healthy. Regularity in exercise is imperative for the preservation of good health. It is good source of energy, stamina, and strength. Lack of it cannot bring good health. So we should be very regular and consistent in physical exercise. Physical exercise is a form of discipline. It means self-control and sincerity. We need to neglect our idleness. Physical exercise helps in building character. It makes our mind sharp and active. It improves mental strength and capability. It adds to our capability and improves our performance. Physical exercise done in the morning keeps us healthy, fit, and active for the whole day. Therefore, we should take it regularly. It is a must to keep us fit and healthy.